What makes a photo feel like a movie? It's all in the color. Today I'm showing you how to get that cinematic look in Lightroom with simple tweaks and a few pro tricks. Let's make your photos look like film, one slider at a time. I have this simple photo of a steering wheel in a vintage car. There are limited colors, but we'll see how we can work on this, though first need to make it flat for flexibility. Shooting in RAW makes it easier, though you can use the basic light panel nonetheless. Here in the light menu, increasing the exposure just a bit to brighten the overall image. Also, just a hint of contrast. Reducing highlights for details in the brighter parts and increasing shadows for details in the darker areas. Also, increasing the whites and reducing blacks for more punch. Now, moving to tone curves to tune some contrast and also grading the color. First, in the RGB curve, I'm going to lift the blacks and also you can bring down the whites to get a faded look. To compensate this, I'm going to bring down the shadows a bit and lift the midtones and the highlights to add some contrast back. Moving to the red curve, dragging it towards right adds cyans to the image. Here I'm going to drag the red curve only for the shadows and move the curve left for more warmer tones. So cooler cyan tones in the shadows and warmer red tones in the highlights. Moving to the blue curve, I'm going to do something similar, though the grade is a bit opposite. Bringing down the shadows to give some yellow tones to the shadows and dragging the curve towards left to add bluish tones to the highlights. Okay, now we are going to jump into the color menu and hit up the grading panel. This is where we can really fine tune the colors in the shadows, midtones and highlights. First up, the shadows. I'm going to add some cool cyanish tones to those darker areas, keeping the saturation around 25 so it's not too overpowering. Then for the midtones, I'm adding some subtle orangish tones to warm things up a bit. And for the highlights, I'm going with even more orangish tones, maybe with a little touch of yellow in there. Finally, to give the whole image a bit of a moody feel, I'm going to nudge the balance slider more towards the blue side. It just kind of ties everything together and creates a cool vibe. Now, moving to the HSL sliders in color menu mix for tuning individual colors. Starting with the red hues, moving them towards orange, which gives the image a major shift towards teal and orange look. Moving the orange hues just a bit towards red with some added saturation. Yellows too, moving towards left for orange tones. Not much green in the image, but for general use, you can move it towards cyan. Cyan hues more towards blue. Blue hues towards cyan. Decreasing its saturation as we are here going for more pop on the oranges, including the skin tones in case you have any people in the image. Alright, so after getting the colors just right, I'm going for a softer, more cinematic vibe. So over in the effects menu, I'm gonna pull that clarity slider down a bit. You can see it kind of smooths everything out and gives it that film-like feel. To really draw your eye to the center, I'm also adding a touch of V-net. Just playing around with the sliders here to get it looking nice and subtle. And you know how movies sometimes have that cool, slightly grainy look? I'm adding a bit of that here too. I'll probably stop the grain slider around 25 or so, but it really depends on the picture. I'll keep the size around 25 as well to match. It just adds that little extra something. Okay, so I messed with the clarity earlier, but now I want to bring back some sharpness, but only in certain spots. So I'm diving into the detail menu and playing with the masking slider. As I slide it to the right, you can see it kind of picks out the edges where the sharpening will happen. Then I'm cranking up the sharpening just on these selected areas. It's pretty cool because it gives you that crisp detail where you want it, but the rest of the image stays nice and soft. Definitely helps to keep things from looking too harsh overall. Okay, there's one more trick I want to throw in at the end to really make this image pop. We're gonna play with masking filters. So I'm grabbing a radial filter here and shaping it into a narrow oval in this area. Gonna crank up the feathering to 100 so it blends in smoothly. Then I'm bumping up the exposure and adding some warm tones to mimic a cool sun flare effect right there. To make it even brighter in the middle, I'm just gonna duplicate that same mask and tweak it a bit. You could also use linear filters to make one side of the image brighter, which can look really cool sometimes. But for this one, I think the radial filter is doing the trick. It just adds that extra bit of interest. I'm gonna move some sliders to get the contrast we are going for. Now, for that important step I was talking about earlier, and honestly, it's super simple. We're heading over to the profiles panel and you just want to make sure the selected profile is Adobe neutral. What this does is give the image a really flat kind of raw starting point. Take a look at the before and after. It's subtle, I know, but it makes a huge difference in how pleasing the image looks. It just gives you a much better base to work from. This is just one way to get that kind of cinematic vibe in Lightroom, but it's a really good one to have in your toolkit. If you want to apply this on other images, for example, I have this time a picture with people in it. We'll go to the other retouched image, tap on the three-dot menu, copy settings, come back to the untouched image, paste the copied settings here. Almost instantly you get this graded look. If you're not happy with the contrast or skin tones, you can always do slight adjustments in the light menu or the HSL sliders in color menu mix. Also making sure the profile selected is Adobe neutral. Let me know your thoughts in the comments if you want other cinematic looks. Hope the video was useful to you all and subscribe for more. Thank you for watching.